Okay, so now for the final step for getting Fallout New Vegas to be as stable as we can possibly make it right now, we are going to start by downloading the New Vegas Stutter Remover, which you can find by Googling New Vegas Stutter Remover, or head over to the Nexus, and you can find it pretty quickly that way. The newest version of this is 4.1.36 at the time of this recording. You'll go ahead and download that and enable it just like you would any other mod. And once it's installed, there it is. Wait, there it is. Once it's installed and enabled, we're going to go to the desktop and we're going to create a new folder and we're going to name it NVSE. And what we're going to do now is click inside the folder and create new text document, and we're going to call it NVSE dot ini. Yes, and you want it to be a configuration settings file type. So we'll open that up and we'll paste this inside. I will have this line for you over on my website. And click Save. And this ini folder is going to basically act the same way as the memory patch for Skyrim, only New Vegas. Now we'll just click outside of that, and we will send this entire folder to a compressed zipped file. Go into Mod Organizer and install the archive we just created. And make sure it's called NVSE. Click OK. I already have it, so I'm just going to replace it. You won't get that. So now, one last thing we need to do, because the line in our NVSE file is set to 450. We need to make a small change to New Vegas Stutter Remover so that it matches. So right-click on it and head to Information. If you are not using Mod Organizer, you're going to go into your mods installation directory, and you're going to have to find it that way. I'm not going to cover that. So, you'll go into information, you will open all these up, and you will locate the New Vegas Stutter Remover dot ini. And you're going to right click and click open. And now we're going to scroll down to where it says heap and find where it says iheap size. And set that to 450 as well. And once that's done, just click Save and Close. And that is the last step. Everything should be set up perfectly to minimize the potential of crashes and stutters and other gameplay altering effects for your Fallout New Vegas. Feel free to start piling in your mods and experimenting as you please.